So hello everyone, welcome back. As I promised that I will be giving you the idea that how I did my summer internship and what all steps I took in it to help you guys. So here I am. The topic was to increase the servo motor cycle oil MCO sales during 2021. And this project I have done under the guidance of B.C. Jindal sir and S.C. Gupta sir, which I am very grateful and I really thank them for providing their guidance and opportunity to work with IOCL. Thank you, sir. And I would also like to extend my gratitude towards my partner Harshit, who helped me in every step of this project. So, giving a brief, let us break down this whole research in three parts. The first is research, second is survey form, and third is report and conclusion. So, talking about research. So, in the research part, we read around 15 to 20 research papers which were already published in lubricant industry. So it gave us the idea about how it is like and what are the factors, what are the key drivers of the industry. So based on that, after 2 weeks, we were asked to make a survey form and to circulate the form and get it filled. So we get it filled from 200 customers, and based on that, we made the report and came to a conclusion and provided our recommendations to the company. So let us get started. So this was the PPT which was made after the report. I will be sharing and I'll be showing the report to you guys also, along with the certificate which I received from the organization. So let us get started with the PPT. Okay. So this is the slide which we kept up about the Indian Oil Corporation Limited to introduce about the company. So in normal words, we can say that IOCL is commonly known as Indian Oil in oil, and it is the government oil owned company, and we can say that it is the largest commercial enterprise in India, and it is ranked among 96th in Fortune 500 companies, and 59% share of market of petroleum product in the country is owned by IOCL, and 31% of the national refining capacity is IOCL's. So it is the second largest petrochemical player in the country, and it employs more than 34,000 of the people. So this is a brief introduction about the company. So the products in which company deals is petrol, gasoline, motor spirit, then lubricants, then automotive greases, then lubricating automotive oil and specialty oil. So our project was on 2T and 4T engine. 2T means two stroke engine, 4T means four stroke engine, and the products were Skynetic Ultra 2T oil, Servo LML 2T oil, and so on. And for the 4T, it was Servo 4T synthetic, Servo 4T zoom, and Servo 4T. Coming to the introduction about the two-wheeler sales in India. So this is the graph which is taken from statistica.com, and it shows the vehicle sales in million units. That is, in 2010, it was 11.77 million units, and it increased to 21.18 in 2019, that is last year. So we can see how dramatic is the increase of two-wheelers in India. So this shows that our country has a huge potential of two-wheelers sales, and as well as the sale of lubricant which is used in two-wheelers in India. So then coming to the next slide, so this is the distribution channel of the lubricant. Especially we have done it for IOCL. So distribution channel comprises of 10 blending plants, 35 CFAs, and then 15 stockists, and then entire bazaar shop. The marketing channel of lubricant in India consists of the following, that is petrol station, then wholesale distribution, then lubricant oil shop, then automotive spare part shops, then service centers, garages, and then rural and agriculture dealers. So these all players, these petrol station and these people, wholesale distributor, these are the players of the market, and these comprises the distribution channel of the lubricant industry in India. So coming to the next slide, then coming to the market share of the lubricant oil in industry, there are four players like Indian Oil, Bharat Petroleum, Hindustan Petroleum and Castrol, which comprises of 80% of the chunk, that is this much, and other 20%, this pink one remaining, is Gulf, ELF and Tidewater Company and AGIP and Shell. So this is the market share, so in which Indian Oil is the largest player, we can see, with 30% share of the market. Okay, then coming to the next slide. So we have done the SWOT analysis for servo lubricant oil. So we have broken its strengths, weakness, opportunities and threats. The strengths are, it holds a very strong distribution channel of 315 stockists. Technology is great, R&D is great, GCS, that is Grameen Seva Samiti scheme, is getting promoted in the rural areas, the lubricant sales. Then coming to the weakness of the company. The company lacks promotion strategy somewhere. There is lack of command on distribution channel because it's so wide. Third is lack of focus on rural market, lack of display of products in RO, that is merchandising in ROs. Coming to the opportunities of IOCL, increased sales in rural markets. There is a huge potential, as I told in the previous slide, that the sales of two-wheelers is increasing. So we have a potential in rural market. Then we can have a tie-up with OEMs, that is original equipment manufacturers, that is the bikes of Yamaha and the bikes of Honda. I mean, the companies directly who are manufacturing the bikes. Then more advertisement in the market is required. Tie-up with a local mechanic, since mechanic form the basic core of any oil sale in the market. Like, for example, if I am saying that if my father goes to a shop, that he to a shop, he's not that techno and into the advertisement industry, so he'll just rely on the mechanic idea of changing the oil. So view of mechanic forms a very great role. It plays a very important role. So then coming to the threats of the company, as we can say that threat can come anytime, like this COVID pandemic 19, and then existing players are giving a tough competition. Then coming e-vehicles in the market, then high cost of production is all, of course, the threat of the company. Then in this slide, we have shown the customer buying behavior, and which in the, that is the factors which influence the customer behavior. First is brand awareness, that is the top of the mind recall, which brand, like if we are going to buy a toothpaste, the first thing which comes into the mind is Colgate or Pepsodent. So similarly, it should be the top of the mind recall, the brand should come at the top of the mind. Second is, key influences are mechanics, as I already told, and decision maker in the family, TV and print ads. Then key considerations can be price in India, pickup of the vehicle, increase in engine life, power in the sound, and long lasting lubrication of the engine. And then price sensitivity, the customer are highly price sensitive, and some people require it in small packaging also. So these were the factors which influence the customer behavior. Then coming to the key drivers of lubricant industry, the drivers are additives, base oil, packaging, finished lubricant, blending and marketing. So these can minimize the cost, and by optimizing the operations and maximizing the cost by sales and distribution channel and customers, and improving the channels, we can maximize the returns. So then, as I already have shared with you the survey, online survey. So these were the results which we found, and that is 63% of the people were using 100 to 200 cc bikes, and the type of engine was 4T engine, that is 71.3%. So the preferred lubricant oil was synthetic oil, and 82% of our applicants were living in urban areas. So their monthly travel was within 0 to 500 kilometers. That this shows that they use it for the local source of transport. Then how many kilometers do you change your motorbike oil? So this was a mixed, and 39.9 were the range in which 100 to 1000 to 1500 kilometers. So this shows that half of the people are ignorant in changing their lube oil. Then the preference purchase lube oil was from retail outlets, it was 58%, and from bazaar shop it was 42%. So this shows that even bazaar shop also are a very key influencer, and we need to work on them. Then is company providing proper advertisement? So people said that 33.3 people said that, percent people said that yes. So we also need to work on the advertisement part of the company. Coming to different brands in which we give the customers options. So 59.3 was Castrol. So this shows that Castrol is at the top of mind recall of the people. And then which lube oil you prefer? Then 59 Yama lube for the Yamaha bikes. Then coming to the what do you prefer for the current lube oil? Then attractive packaging suggests vehicle. Then see, this shows that 83.5% people are working as the view of their mechanic, and 55.6 people are agreeing about the buying decision that brand is the major factor which influence the selling of oil. So then the final question was asked to whether the discount or value-added services is required. So 60% of the people said yes to it. So this was the analysis which I already told that from the graph. So same thing is written here. So these are some of the recommendations which we are giving to the company, that customer are not aware about the servo lube oil. So company should give efforts in marketing strategies in rural areas and somewhat in some suburban areas, and company should establish QOC, that is quick oil change money machine, so that customers are lured to buy the lubricant oil. And then company should provide loyalty card so that customer keeps up coming back. And then company should focus on tie-ups with local mechanics, and by surveying more people, that is, they will, I mean, the view is of the local mechanic. And the company should also focus on merchandising of their lubricant and RO shops. And then company should approach the OEM, that is original oil manufacturers, to increase their sales. So these were the recommendations based on the survey. So these are the learning outcomes of our project, that is IOCL corporate structure, and we learned about IOCL. Then two-wheeler market in India we learned about. Then distribution channel and a market share of lubricant oil of IOCL. Then customer buying behavior and key drivers of the industry, and impact of COVID and strategies to improve sale. And that's all. These were the learning outcomes. So with this, I come to the end of my presentation of summer internship. So I hope that